I've always had an active imagination. At 5, it's normal. Cute, even. At 14, it's a worry. But at 23, single and estranged from your own father, well, it's problematic. Here's my argument. With your imagination, you're never disappointed. People are who you make them. Hey, without it, I'd never have met Janet. She was beautiful, and within seconds, I had a story. Janet, age 22, single of course, an anti-war underwear model. At first, nothing changed. Put Dad on the phone. I want to talk to Dad. Why won't he talk to me? But soon, it all went a little weird.
Temper, temper.
Pretty soon, we were inseparable. We'd talk for hours. Be it my love of literature or the nature of the female psyche. Janet had a keen ear and even made me think twice about my grammar. But sadly, like all good things and perishable goods, it wasn't to last. I started to see my father's point of view. Maybe it was time to get serious. Janet went into the drawer and I was washed over by a sea of anticlimax. As it turned out, moving on was harder than anticipated. I began sensing Janet all around, thinking I'd seen her. On the bus, at the shop, even in my tall Americana. I'd found objects I swore she'd used, and that carrying them gave me a confidence, which until then, I could only dream of. I sent food back, and returned that DVD. I knew what I had to do. I had to find her. Maybe that'd show my father. I wasn't just a waster. Maybe I would get my lingering kiss, fade to black. But one thing was for sure. I wasn't going to get it drinking coffee. Plan A began. The next few days were hard. I still wanted to ring my dad, but I had to keep the line clear for Janet. Or at least, that's what I told myself. Then suddenly, hey?
Do I sound like I'm missing?
What? Well...
Well, I'm Katie. Katie Andrews. Starry little posters, and I'm not missing. A fact it's taken me the last hour to convince my friends of. If you try anything like this again, I'm calling the fucking police.
But... I'd fathom two things. Her name was Katie, and I was teetering dangerously on the brink of a restraining order. I needed to think. And I soon came up with Plan B. Through my Kojak wisdom and the Freedom of Information Act, I had her in my sights. It was to be a morning assault.
Yeah?
I resisted the temptation to kick him in the nuts. I wasn't wearing suitable footwear.
Listen, if you're selling something...
I'm a friend of Katie's. It was clearly her, but something was different. Was the picture just a moment in time? One she may never better.
I suppose I could say it ended there. Save myself the embarrassment of a beating. But, you know, it's important.
It's like what my dad told me about working in the graveyard shift. He went to the Christmas party and didn't know anyone. You could say the same about life. No matter how close you are, you never really know it all. I just choose to fill in the gap.
Nothing, are you alright?
Cheers, thanks. Yeah, I'm fine, thanks. Oh, I'm Declan, by the way.
Hi, I'm Janet. Lady,
where's your love gone? Well... one more try can't hurt. They always offer when there's loads of love around. When you're short of some, it's nowhere to be found. Well, I know your game. You told him yesterday, no chance you get nothing from me. But now she's there, you're there, and everybody's there. He's in turmoil, as puzzled as can be. Just like me, let's go down, down, low down. Where I know I should not go. Oh, and she thinks she's the one, but she's just one in 24. And just 'cause everybody's does that mean that I can too? Lady, where's your love gone? It was the antiseptic to the sore. So hold you by the